Say that again. What was that?
When Isaac bought that right-hand drive Acura or whatever it was.
Yeah.
Said, hey, how's that car? He goes, oh, it's great, except I can't go through the drive-thru.
Yeah.
I'll bring somebody with me.
So, we brought this, well, the U.S. Postal Office brought this CRV, right-hand drive. They needed the axles to be replaced on it. What's funny is that it's four lug. Now, the funnier thing is, most of the Accords, they are 36 millimeter axles. But I have a feeling this one sits on 92-93 Honda Accord suspension, maybe, or bearings, because this one sits on a 32 millimeter, not a 36. And right now they're having a hard time finding the axles. So the lady where she bought the car said they sell her parts, so she needed an axle because the boots are ripped and it clicks and whatnot. So this is what they sent her. Yeah. So I don't know. This thing might vibrate like no other. So what they're doing is they're using the B series inner axle and the outer of a 32 millimeter. But what they don't know is that it's, you can just use a normal B series axle like Integra. I don't know why they're doing that. And they're selling them for pretty expensive, and this is what you're getting. I think they're paying like over $150 for this axle. And right now, Ricardo's trying to find another axle, but they're not gonna find it because it's 32. And obviously the inner, it's normal. So if you get any B series axle, it's gonna be a 36 millimeter. So that's where we're at. And I'm telling them we're just gonna have to use Integra axles. So, yeah. That's kind of funny. To me, I was like, why would they do that? And this is the guys that, somewhere in Utah. Yeah. So, that's that. What did he say?
He said he can't get it.
He can't get it?
No.
They will not physically go in the hub. The splined part is too big. And then there is like the Integra, which would be the one that fits in there, is an inch too long. And you can't even get the knuckle close to the lower ball joint hole. You can't even get the lower ball joint in with the long CV axle. So if you can at least, if you can get that lower ball joint hole lined up and you can get it in there, I haven't had a problem with one. They don't make any vibrations. They don't do anything funny. They just work. So I don't know if you're able to get that and you're just, it might be a little too long and it's a little tight in there. I don't know. I can't physically see what you're physically messing with in it. But what I can tell you is that I have probably put 10 of these CV axles in both sides. Doesn't matter, either or. I haven't had a single problem with them. They fit right in. And they work. So that's why I said if you could, if you're really thinking that it's, you said an inch too long, is what I would do.
Okay.
And because I'll
put it next to it.
Because they do vary in length when you pull a stock one out and you're looking at a new one, they do look different. But they do fit. They do go right in. They pop right in. No problems. I haven't had a single issue. Even the ones without the vibration damper on them for
yeah.
the passenger side,
uh-huh.
It doesn't even matter if that's on there or not.
All right, man. Well,
I swear, yeah. I promise you.
Well, yeah, I'll see what the customer, if the customer wants to go with it, then we'll do it, you know?
Yeah, yep. No, and I agree. You can only do what the customer wants. I 100% guarantee that is the way to go. But like I said, I have probably put 10 of these or more in and haven't had an issue. I do believe we have some remanufactured ones that are from these Hondas.
We couldn't find any axles that are comparable or shareable. This one is in between the D series and the B series. The D series is too small, the B series is too big. It's in between. It has a 32 millimeters splines outside or the outer, but yeah, I don't know. We just decided to just take them out and reboot them. This one's already rebooted with new boots. Same as this one. And we're gonna do both, because you can see this one's the same, it's ripped. Yeah. Same thing in the inside. So that's the only thing that was wrong with it. She said after we compared them, the one that she bought, it was too long, like an inch too long. So we decided to not use it. Afterwards, she's gonna send it back. And it was $250 something. So yeah, we told her. I don't know, the dude was saying he's done it before, he's done 10 of them and they don't have any complaints, but for some reason in this one they missed because it was too long. So yeah. Okay, I'm back at it again. So we were gonna replace the boots, those, on the passenger, well on this one's a passenger, but it would be the left hand side. And then turns out this one is the same as a 90. I got this one from a 99 Acura Integra. It's a 99 Acura Integra manual transmission, so same thing. Dude, why are you running like crazy? Huh?
I'm busy as hell, man.
And we got a new helper over there, right?
Yeah.
What is his experience?
Changing the blinker fluid.
Changing the blinker fluid. Nice. So anyways, yeah, this one fits. So that's crazy because this thing has different mismatch axles. The driver's, the passenger side, well shoot, I'm confusing, it would be the right side on this one is, I don't know what the hell it's from. It's not a D series and it's not a B series unless it's an Accord, some type of a model of an Accord, but it didn't fit, so we had to do the boots. But the left hand side, it's the same length, same everything as the 99 Integra manual transmission. So we're gonna go ahead and replace that. The reason was because the axle was only $54. And how much were the boots? Like 60 something?
60 something, yep.
Yeah.
Oh, 70.
70?
Yeah, 74, 74, 29.
Yeah, $54 for the axle through AutoZone. And it was a no-brainer because I had to go through all that. Probably it's gonna take me an hour or two to do the boots, clean them and whatnot, grease them up. And then these things are $69. So I told Ricardo, let's just go ahead and see if the axle fits, which in this case it did. And it's faster and we're just gonna do that. And at least now she knows that the axle on the left hand side, it's the same as an Integra. So it's a quick replacement. But this side it's not. This side I bought the axle. It's over here. But it didn't work. It's different. I bought the axle, but it just didn't fit. The D series, the splines are too small. The B series won't fit. I don't know what it's out of, but it didn't work. So that's that. I'm gonna put it on, lower it, and call her in so she can come pick it up. How much did she say she paid for it? $17,000, huh?
$17,000
for a weird four lug right hand drive CRV. And yeah, well it's more likely for her work. Yeah, but yeah, 17k. And then that axle that I showed you guys, she took it, she's gonna return it. We told her it wasn't, one of them it was too long, and two of it, the second of all, I told her she was gonna feel a big vibration. And yeah, so that's that. All right, well, we got some parts that came in. Aaliyah's parts came in, and Isaac Jones. I've been waiting for this part for a long time. No, this is Aaliyah's parts. This is Isaac Jones. I've been waiting for this part for the longest time. It got rejected. I don't know why. And then all of a sudden, he said it was on its way. Keep saying it's on its way. It's been a month and barely showed up. Also, I was on a page, a K-Series page, and I came across one of my buddies. Not my buddies. I've known him for a while. I sold him one of my white hatchbacks. His name is Miguel Valencia. He went fully race car on that car. I'll see if I can find some pictures of it. But anyways, he posted this Capro. It's a Capro V3. He posted it for $500, five something. I think it was $550. And I was like, man, that's pretty cheap for being a V3. So I decided to buy it. I messaged him. He had just posted it like 5 minutes. That was last, I think it was Monday. And I told him, hey, I'll buy it. And he says, yeah, dude, send me some money and I'll send it your way, because I don't. Says, now you have the power. Oh, is that so? So then why are you selling it, bro? I think he said he was going to go, he's going to go Capro B4. So, yeah. Anyways, that's that. I'm going to go ahead and go back to work. I have to come back later. All right. Well, looks like she's ready to go. That's crazy how they have that GPS on it. Oh, I mean, not the GPS, the navigation system. Yeah, this one was a... This one was made my brain hurt for a bit. Like I said, this one's a Ford Lug. I don't know why. I'm kind of willing, but no, it's the same thing. That the problem is the inner part of that axle that it doesn't fit. I was gonna say, because I'm kind of willing to tell her, you know, you can make a 5 lug, but that's not the issue. The issue is the axle. It's not.